from Roswell, New Mexico. This is Red Bull Stratos, mission to the edge of space. I'm Robert Hager, coming to you from Mission Control, where miles high in the stratosphere, during which he also hopes to become the first human being ever to break through the sound barrier while falling. That's the balloon that'll lift him aloft, the biggest balloon ever used for a manned flight. And down the line for that balloon in a pressurized capsule, there it is, the pressurized capsule in which Baumgartner will ride up, suspended below the balloon. He's inside that capsule, and from which he'll make his historic jump. There's Baumgartner inside, a camera inside the capsule, showing him, waiting, anticipating. All this expected, too, to have implications for the future safety of space travel. The science and engineering team assembled for the Red Bull Stratos project hopes to collect valuable data from today's jump to help find ways for astronauts, high-altitude pilots, or even one day space tourists to safely bail out in an emergency from altitudes higher than anyone has ever dared think of until now. So we're moments away from launch. And here's what will happen. There you see the balloon over on the left side of the screen, and the long tail, that's 200 yards of tail, a tether, and a parachute that will later be used to parachute the capsule down, attached to the capsule, which was way over on the right-hand side of the screen. And as we move through this, there will be a delicate choreograph here. There's the capsule over on the right-hand side of the screen. You see the little crane. Underneath that is the capsule. It's hard to see, just a tiny dot on the right-hand side of the screen. So as the balloon's tail is released and the bubble starts to rise, the crane carrying the capsule must move directly underneath the rising bubble and wait until the line up to the balloon is taut. Then, only then, release the capsule to rise with the balloon. It's all got to be done very carefully, because you don't want that capsule bumping into the ramp or bumping along the ramp as the bubble rises. That would be a danger to the rider inside the capsule, Felix Baumgartner. In fact, this whole business, the launch, is one of the more delicate portions of the day's event, the jump being by far the most serious. But this particular maneuver has its risks too. Number one, I just described the issue to avoid bumping the capsule along the launch pad. But number two, as the balloon rises, should there be a problem when it's only a few hundred or a thousand feet off the ramp, there's not enough time for Baumgartner to get that door open, but he couldn't get the parachute open. That is a problem. Now here we go. There's the bubble rising. There's the tail going out. The crane will move forward. So far we've got a good start. Crane moving forward now. Winds are going hot, waiting. Far. Beautiful shot there. The release, and there it was, a successful ride.
You're going up your screen.
Successful rise off the desert floor and the launching ramp here in Roswell, New Mexico. All right, we're still in a risky position here until they get 4,000 feet.
Because
So when the balloon reaches float altitude, Baumgartner will dump the pressure in the capsule, step out onto the little porch. So you see how that heat is rising outside now, the temperature. It dropped down to as low as 90 degrees below zero, 90-something below zero. Now it's coming back up again. That's what happens in the stratosphere. It gets colder as you go higher and higher, and then at a point you reach the coldest. And now because you're getting into thinner air and actually reducing the distance to the sun, the atmosphere or stratosphere in this case slowly begins to warm again. Feet now, 28,000 meters.
Thank you.
So no one is precisely sure where this balloon will stop as it floats up. It was calculated mathematically to stop at about 120,000 feet, maybe 125,000 feet. But in the previous two jumps, the balloon has gone higher than Mission Control calculated. Those were Baumgartner's previous two jumps earlier this year. Their Mission Control, the team, still working that issue of the trouble with the heat in the faceplate or visor, considering the options of what to do about that, trying to analyze what the source of it is. But the basic problem was reported as a, at least Baumgartner's perception, that the visor was not heating as it should. This is Red Bull Stratos, Mission to the Edge of Space, coming to you live from Roswell, New Mexico. So 2 minutes.
Keep talking, Felix. Keep talking.
Still can't quite make that out, but reassuring to hear his voice. And you can see how he's in control there. That's showing you the supply of oxygen in his oxygen bottles.
Yes, Felix, I hear you. Go ahead. Roger, go ahead. Go ahead, Felix, I hear you. Go ahead.
Good evening. I have been following speak for a long time. I have like a half hour.
Still free calling.
Really stable. You fought in 3.5 minutes.
Record.
I have been told before because my riser is fucking up. I repeat, my riser is fucking up.
So you can understand that. He said his visor was fogging up, but he's getting to warmer altitudes. There's the chute. There's the chute. Thank you. under parachute now.
Could have done it better myself.
There's from the helicopter
now.
Out of
the north at 5 to 10. Out of the north
under canopy.
And you can contact
floating
Mike Todd
safely,
on this frequency. Give Mike
floating
Todd
safely
call
down
over
to Earth. There's Ava Baumgartner.
The wind's out of the north, 5 to 10. Give Mike
elated
Todd a call
tears of joy
over
from mission control. As Felix now
Felix,
approaches
Ray,
the ground.
The winds here are out of the east. At about 10 to 15.
So we're now at 6,000 feet.
This is Mission Control. Felix's current altitude under the chute is 6,600 feet.
On each direction.
So he has the highest
we're
jump.
For you, bud. We can't find you. There's one that you just worked.
There he is. There's a closer shot from the helicopter.
Felix, the wind's out of the north, 5 to 10.
Beautiful shot.
Facing that big tower. Anybody can hear, I'm facing that big tower.
Okay, and the wind's out of the east. I'm sorry, I give you the wrong information. Out of the east.
On your Felix, we're coming your way, bud.
Hurry up, I need
glare. Approaching Earth.
Felix, wind is out of the east. The wind is out of the east.
Under parachute, you have...
We're coming your way right now.
Quite a bit of control. By pulling this...
Hurry up. Land down and
show me
the direction.
Wind out of the east, Felix. Wind out of the
by
east.
By pulling the cords, he can control a fair amount of control on his path into this landing. Now we see that scrub earth below.
Felix's altitude is 5,800 feet.
Just 5,000 feet now, so really nearing. And the altitude out there, I'm not sure of the altitude of the ground.
Hey, drop some clear, Daddy. Drop some fucking clear.
Luke's making the call to drop smoke, Felix.
That means to drop a smoke marker from one of the helicopters. Oh, he wanted to see, I see. He wanted the smoke so he could see the wind direction.
Hey, Felix, the wind is coming from the ridge. The wind is coming from the ridge. No, towards the ridge.
Art Thompson,
the wind is
technical director
the ridge
of the Red Bull Status Program, telling him that the wind is coming from the direction of that ridge I was talking about. So he certainly got the highest jump mark that he was after. We'll find out about the Mach. Break the speed of sound as he hoped. There he's down on his knee.